Hello and welcome to another brand new video of this The Lazy Coder channel. Today I am super excited because I have come up with two exciting projects. The first one is about writing in the air just like this, and the second one is about getting invisible just like this. Okay, not like this, but like this. I have completed these two projects more than a month before. But as you can guess from the channel's name, I am too lazy to put all the stuff together and made a video out of it. But now I am able to do it, and without taking more of your time, let's start the video. To start with, we'll watch the demonstration of the projects at first, and then I will mention you some core things about the project. As these are fun projects, I will not go that much into deeper, but I will mention how it works and what difficulties you can face while doing these projects. So let's move on to the demonstration part, and at first we will watch the virtual pen demonstration. Here is my webcam got opened, and what I am writing in the air is now getting printed over my screen. Isn't it cool? I am just writing my name, Shoumik, over the screen. In a second, you will watch the magic. Okay, now. It's not a magic. I have just set the buffer size to banish my name from the screen. What is the buffer size and how does the project work? I am coming with it later section of the video. For now, we will watch the demonstration of invisible clock. So, I have passed the command for my invisible clock on the terminal, and my webcam just got opened once again. You have to say Ivanesco or magic like me to get disappeared from the screen like the movie of Harry Potter. Just kidding. Okay, my gesture was not like Harry Potter. I have to wear it like a chadar. Now I look like Harry Potter. Okay, so here is our demonstration part, and we will just move on to the next section quickly. I have used Adrian Rosbrock's ball tracking algorithm for my virtual pen project, and you can see in my virtual pen project code on my GitHub repo. There is nothing much. If you have noticed or not, I was just using a pen which has a blue head. Okay, so I was just tracking a blue object and drawing over the tracking of the blue object. Okay, so I have included the HSB color space values for green, blue and red in my code. Though I am doing with the blue one, I have just added the green and red one for your help. If any of you are doing it with a red pen or a green pen or any other green or blue, red or blue object. Okay, so rest part of the code is just about grabbing the frames and just tracking the blue objects in the video, and just keep tracking of the coordinates of the blue object. Okay, so why are we keeping the record of tracked blue object? Because what we are doing, we are just drawing a line between the previous tracked coordinates of our blue object and the current tracked coordinates of our blue object. With the help of this algorithm, we can draw or write something in the screen as we move our blue object over the screen. Okay. I think that you have got this algorithm, and for now, let's explore the invisible clock project. So here is my GitHub repository of invisible clock, and both of the project's algorithm are quite same. Previous one, we are just tracking the blue object and drawing line over the tracking. Okay, and what we are doing now, we are just tracking a particular color object and just replacing the particular color object with the previously recorded background. Okay. And I have done a different technique to determine the HSB color space of your desired object, which is written in this which is written in this color range detector dot py. And how you can deal with this particular Python file is written super simply in my readme section. And if you run it with the terminal, three cameras will be open, naming thresh, original and trackbars. The trackbars are for HSD color difference. By just sliding the bars, you can make difference in values of H, S and B. And the thresh display is for detecting your desired object. I am using my red color clock here, and I have to adjust the HSD values till my desired object becomes totally white and rest become totally black. And the most fine tune you can do this, the most final your result will be. Next, if we look at our invisible.py, we'll see that we are just pickling the values that we have manually set in our color range detector.py, and we are just capturing the background for 60 times, and we are detecting our desired color and replacing the background with our desired color. So when we replace our background with the desired color, we become invisible. So here was the algorithm. I think you have got it. And these two projects are super simple to do, and I have written the whole process. I have written the whole process super simply in my readme section. You can just follow this and you will be able to get invisible, and you will be able to write in your screen.
So this was it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Stay happy till I see you in another exciting video, and subscribe the channel.